Hello, everybody, and welcome to Let's Play Anno 2070 with me, 1F Me. And I just briefly explain the game real quick. Anno 2070 is a city-building strategy game, I guess I would call it. Similar in a lot of ways to Tropico, Civilization, and a game that not a lot of people, I don't think, are familiar with, but what really struck me as the reason that I wanted to play the game was because it reminded me a lot of a game called Civ City Rome, which I was a huge fan of back in the day. I can no longer play that on Windows 7 computers, and that makes me sad, but, or at least not at the optimal way, anyway. I think something screwed up with the resolution or something like that. At any rate, it's a very interesting game in that it evolves the concept of those types of games quite a ways. Now, most people that know Anno know it from its other portion of the series, Anno 1440 or Anno 17-something, which were respectively medieval Renaissance-type games wherein you did the same city-building type of thing, but it was with, you know, merchant fleets in olden days made of wood and cannons and shit, I don't know. Anyway, this one's in the future. And as I like to call it, Anno 2070, the future of Buttsex. very mature here, you can tell. Still mature, still very very adult-like in our in our concepts of the game. But the way in which the game has evolved some of these concepts is actually really interesting, and I quite like it. This is the main menu of the game, but it's also sort of an interface in and of itself. We've got a mail system here, and then we've got our own little profile, but there's also the availability of doing mission maps, loading games, and then there's things like these events. So, for example, there's a council vote. You can see that the next vote is going to be in 16 hours, and then when you make your council vote, you impact the kind of things that you can do in a game. The same thing goes with a Senate vote. For example, here was one that was on modernizing maritime shipping, and the bonus for this, which extends to all games, both in campaign mode or in multiplayer mode or in single-player mode, where because of the voting that you took, the bonus that every player receives is productivity increase. So you have a way to impact not only your own game, but other people's games, and there's a whole lot of multiplayer options in here. None of my buddies are online, but we've been playing around with it a little bit, and it's quite fun. And then there's events that occur every once in a while. I haven't played a lot of these, but this one is a stock market crash event in which you do a mission in the objective of earning credits through trade. And those will change and whatnot as you continue to play the game. So what's interesting about it is it's got this sort of metagame thing going on, and another thing is this. This is the arc configuration page of your profile. You can change your portrait and your color and stuff like that, but what's interesting to me is the arc is sort of like your player base. Whenever you start a new game or map, your arc is placed down, and that's where it's the sort of the central hub of your building thing. And what I find to be really interesting is that the things that you do in one game carry over onto your arc from another game. So, like, these things are in the storage of my arc, and these were stored here from playthroughs that I had done on another game. Same with these. These are global upgrades that are slotted into my upgrade slots on my arc, and they were earned in one game, and then they carry over into another game. So if you perform very well in one game, like, for example, in the campaign, and you receive some upgrades, you can then take those upgrades into another game and sort of level up your arc, if you will, and build your ability to progress from there, so you could do harder and more difficult challenges and campaigns and things like that. I find that to be really interesting, and it also motivates, it gives a nice motivation for advancing your civilization and your technology and stuff like that, because you can research new things to add onto your arc for later. So we're going to be taking our slightly, very slightly upgraded arc. It's not very, you know, I don't have a whole lot of stuff on here. I have some emergency things, like this is a oil pump to clean up oil spills, because that's something that I find happens a whole hell of a lot. But with that said, after the long spiel, we're going to be doing a continuous game. There's a number of different types of games that you can do here. These are the world events ones. There's single missions, all sorts of different scenarios that you can do where you have objectives to gain a certain amount of wealth or a certain population level. There's a campaign which I have completed. It was very interesting and difficult, and also not that good, but what are you gonna do? There's multiple multiplayer modes, one where you can play cooperatively, or you can play this one, whoops, which is Dominion, and it's more of a competitive mode. All of this goes through Uplay as well, because this is an Ubisoft game, and so, love it or hate it, it's got that DRM on it, and you're gonna be shit on if you don't have an internets. So I recommend you have an internets if you plan to check out the game. But we're gonna be doing a continuous game, and we're gonna set up some custom stuff here in a minute. Alright, so there's Easy, which is sort of, you know, a sandbox place for you to play without much concern or difficulty. Normal is the one that we're going to be playing on. We'll do some different options in this to make it more difficult. And the reason I'm not going to do difficult is because it's too fucking difficult. And I'm kind of bad at this game. And by kind of, I mean really bad at this game. So we're going to go with a little bit more difficult scenario. I am going to bump up Leon and Vadim to hard. And the different types of slots of players here have different meanings. For example, this means he's an expanding party. He will continue to grow his empire and bases and have an impact on the game. Same with this guy. One of them is an eco guy. One of them is a tycoon guy. I'll explain a little bit more about that in a moment. And then there's three arc owners along with myself. These guys are sort of neutral parties in the game. They're trading partners, and they have ways of impacting the game through non- either industry or military stuff. And then we've got Hector, who I'll leave on medium. He is a pirate guy. He has his own little pirate base, and he's just constantly going to be fucking with everybody, because that's what he does, and he's a dickhead. We're going to change some of these options, though. For example, I'm going to change the map size to large, and we're going to change the island size to also large. We'll keep the fertilities and stuff to medium. I'll explain a little bit about what that stuff is. I am gonna keep my arc storage on, even though it does start me with some interesting stuff that's gonna make my life a little bit easier. I don't think it's gonna make it too much easier, and besides, I earned that shit, so fuck you. I'll use it if I want to. I am gonna set a win condition, and that win condition is gonna be fellow players defeated. It's extremely unlikely that we'll get anywhere near there before we're murdered. But there we go. We have it set to a... This says medium, but it should be set to large. No, it still says medium. Why? Large. Okay, so maybe I have to go back and do all these settings again. Yeah, what the fooey? Oh, it's because I hit back. Aw. Okay, so we've got all of our settings made, and you can see we're somewhere just a little bit harder than a normal game, because we've set these guys to hard. And now we're going to go ahead and start the mission. Here's where we choose between the Eden Initiative and the Global Trust. Ostensibly, it doesn't really matter, because after a certain amount of expansion, you'll be able to have both of them at the same time. But in terms of the beginning, this is what you're looking for, is the things you require to grow in the beginning. And I find that the Eden Initiative is a bit easier to manage because of its... system of using eco-energy instead of using coal-powered energy. I find that it's easier to manage, and the environmental impact is not so bad on your cities and stuff. But I'll get into that a little bit more. We're going to be going as Eden, and now we're going to load, which takes forever. Hey, yo, here we go. So, here's our arc. I've got it slightly upgraded. This is not the one you start with. You get this arc for beating the campaign. And we found land! And here's our conditions for victory. We have to beat people. So I'll go over... Whoa, what the fuck? There's some guy right here. It starts you off with one command ship. This guy's name is Okeanos. I'm going to change him to the JSP Herp Derp Prize. In honor of another thing. Hello. So I've got a guy that's like really right next to my house. He's just right fucking here. And... we're going to take a look at this island. This island looks good for me because it has the fertilities that I require. I'm going to talk about that real quickly. Up here, you can look at the island. If I go over to this island, it's got a different name and a different set of fertilities. This particular island has the ability to grow tea, rice, coffee, and it has a slot for an empty fertility, meaning we can change it for later. This is a problem. It doesn't have any sand. It has basalt, we don't need oil or lobsters, but it's also got coal, iron, limestone, copper, and uranium. So, not the best island in the world. This island has sand, though, so we may have to have some sort of a trade agreement with him. Although he also has a bit of a problem here, in that he's got a, looks like some sort of blown-up nuclear power plant or something like that. That's not good. This one is not so bad, though. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to our orc and order a set of tools. We'll take our Herpeter prize here, and we will set up a base right here. Not the perfect place for it, but it'll have to do in a pinch. So this is our warehouse. It holds all of our supplies and things like that. They gave us some fish to start out with. And the first things that we're going to want to do are start building up our infrastructure for the future. So we're going to make a little trade depot right here, and I'll cover what depots and things do for later, but for now we want to start already doing building modules, because that's going to be the primary focus of our game, is building boxes for the first, I don't know, long while. Oh, that's a pain in the vajayjay right there. I can't quite reach that mine with this depot. I can reach that one, so we'll do a little overlap here. If I build one depot here and then another depot here, does that give me? No, I'll have to do it here. Man, what a pain. So we'll have this little spot right here. Depots cover the areas where you can build. So right now, if I go to build something, I can't build it in this area because the depots don't cover it. And they also cover how the goods are retrieved and delivered throughout that area. So in this area here, we're going to start our basalt construction facilities. And basalt is used to create these building materials in a smelter, so we need to create a large infrastructure for that. So I'm going to set up some roads here. The depots have little supply robots that use roads to deliver supplies to places that build things and use things. So, for example, I will set up two smelters here, and I will, two basalt extractors there, and I'll set up a smelter right here. So the way that goods will be delivered is there will be a these guys will deliver directly to this, but there's going to be a little drone robot that'll come down the road and pick up the supplies from there and bring it back to the depot, etc. We have to build some production areas for this basalt extractory. You can do this manually or automagically if you want, but for now we're just going to start off with that. We're going to have a crap load more of those, like 800,000 of those, because you need every box in the beginning of the game. We're also going to pick up our tools that we ordered, and now we need to start defining a city for our people to live. It's going to be right about here, because this is relatively close to where I started, and so we'll just plop down a city center right here. We have an energy shortage, which is a problem, because we're going to need to get people to live here before we can solve that. So we'll need to decide how to build our city out here, and we're going to start with building some houses. We'll go with four there or not. Oh hey, we have the ability to make power now. So these are little wind farms. These are the reasons that I picked eco, is because they give you power and they don't require you to pollute the environment at all. You can see we're still at a zero eco balance, which means that we're not impacting the environment one way or another. And we are currently building a little bit of boxes, not a lot. We need a whole fuck of a lot more. So I'm going to go ahead and start expanding this right now. We don't need to worry about the rest of this stuff for a little bit. We may end up needing to build more city thingamajiggers. Can you go here? That'd be swell. And then you can go here. And then you can put your shit right here. Registering need for sweetness. Community. Oh, I've got to build roads because my houses can't access the city center. No, we need roads. The cities in the game are pretty cool once you've got them figured out. It uses a coverage of facilities system similar to a game like Civ City Rome, wherein the civilians have needs that need to be fulfilled, and those needs are fulfilled based on sometimes proximity and sometimes other things. I don't think I need this road here, actually. Roads again. Alright, so now all these houses are happy because they have access to the community center, the city center here, but they need to get their drink on and they need to get their activity on. What are you yammering about? So, because we built all those houses, we've got more construction options. This guy apparently built something on this island and now inhabits it or something? I don't know, that was an old notification. Either way, we are basalting here, and our facility, that guy is full, so we need to build a new smelter, because we can handle more of them, and the more boxes means more houses means more income. Right now we're losing money because we don't have a whole hell of a lot of houses. Let's see, what's my basalt looking like? We got extra. I need to upgrade this as soon as possible. Because I need to be building more of these transport robots to move goods. But you can see this guy right here. He just picked up something from here and moved it over here. And they're just going to be transferring goods and doing their little production routines all over the place. And the next step for me is to get enough citizens to unlock the concert hall here, which will gain us access to a whole new group. For example, right now we've got eco-workers. The next section will be eco-employees, and then there will be eco-engineers, etc. And every time we unlock a new caste or social group, it'll give us unlocks to access more building things and more requirements for our guys as well. But for now, this is what we've got. And we're starting to build boxes, not as many as I'd like. I want to kind of take a look and see. I think we can support... No, we need more basalt extractors, and we need more smelters. So we're going to continue building more and more and more and more of those. I don't know if this guy's going to be able to do his thing here. No, he's going to have to build one across the damn street. Well, ain't that about a pain? All right, that's fine. We're going to need to build another depot here, too, because we've got so many things being transported. I think we should be getting enough basalt to cover another smelter. And even if we aren't, I'm going to make another smelter. Actually, I'll make it here, and I'll put another depot right here. There we go. That leaves us a little bit of room to expand when the time comes. Can expand this way, like so, and that's a good little production area right there. We have basically a box manufacturing hub. This one's only got one of these, and it's operating at 6% production efficiency, which means that we're going to need more basalt extractors. And this is, again, our major focus right now is building up a basalt manufacturing area. I know that doesn't make a whole hell of a lot of sense, but, you know, just go with me on this one. New buildings available for construction. Yay, we can make tea now. Tea is another thing that is required by our civilians. They need drinks. I'm not focusing too much on building up my city right now. I mostly just want to make sure that we're cranking out as many boxes as possible. I think we're going to need more tools as well. I forgot I haven't transferred these over. We have some other things as well that we can transfer over from some of my other games. For example, this thing here will make my command ship faster and hold more storage capacity, which is pretty cool. We've also got this is a control module, which I can slot into my... I can slot that into my factory here, or my warehouse here, and it'll increase the productivity for a half an hour of everything on the island. I don't know if I can use that, though, because it says... something about researchers. I don't know if that's... There we go. Now we've got increased productivity everywhere. And these guys are getting enough basalt to make themselves happy. I did not mean to click that button at all. And we should be getting a crap load of boxes now. Yeah, we're up to a shitload of boxes, roughly, give or take. So now that we've got a box infrastructure going on, we can start expanding our city a little bit here. This is areas to the sides here. These are going to be for concert halls and other... utility upgrades. Not quite enough boxes to expand it as much as I'd like, but we're making progress. And we need to start building some tea factories. So, I suppose... Oh boy, did I already transfer those tools? No, I didn't. Yeah, I was starting to get a little worried. We're gonna need enough tools to be able to build new tool construction thingamajiggers here. So, let's see. We'll build two of these. Come on. Come on, box makers, make me a box. They're called building supplies, but they look like boxes, so I just call them boxes. Come on, go, little truck. Truck me a box. This one's got a box in it for sure. I know it does. Yes, it gave me a box. Sweetness. All right. So now we will build a tea factory. Why are you crying, tea thingy? He's crying about something. I don't know why. And we'll put some roads. Are we out of power or something? Why is he crying? Oh, it's because there were no roads for it to deliver the tea, probably. Stop crying! Wow, 130%? What is this all about? Oh, it's because of our production bonus there. Also, we have the maritime shipping bonus, and we also have the ecological effect from my slotted upgrades on my thingy, which gives, this one gives me an increase to mobility, commando ship movement, and then we've got the eco balance of reduced something in somewhere. I don't know exactly. But I do know that our fucking ship is super fast. It's got 3 movement upgrades. So it's haul balls fast right now. That's way fast. And we should also be producing boxes out the box zoo. In fact, do we have surplus basalt? Yes, we do. We can hold another smelter. That is amazing news. I guess I'll put it here. You can middle mouse button to rotate buildings. That one took me forever to figure out. Now let's take a look at our houses and see if we have tea supplied. Not quite. I'm assuming that's just because these guys haven't begun to be really productive. I don't think we need that much more in terms of tea production. I'm going to build a road here to connect these two together, just for funsies, and then we'll build another set of roads out here to expand our construction options. Might as well connect these together as well. Or I can build a rando piece of road right there for no reasons. Alright, soon we'll find out if we have enough tea production out of these two to cover all these houses. I don't know if we will or not, but I'm hopeful that we will. And then after that, we're going to need access to the concert hall, which we can already build. So we'll go ahead and build this right here. No, we need more energy. That's okay. We're eco nerds. All we have to do is build a new wind thingy. Yay, eco nerds! Our eco balance did go down, though. I think it's from these, isn't it? No, I don't know what it's from. It's from this. This building gives us -2 eco stuff. Now you can see the only thing we need is drink, and once that happens, we'll be able to upgrade some of our people. And from there, we can start building more advanced buildings and technologies and shit. We'll build another tea factory because I'm a little concerned about my tea production rate here. Hopefully that will cover everybody and then some. What should I say? What about our food? Oh, we're going to need to build fisheries. We've had a set supply of food that we started with, but I forgot to build more fisheries. So we'll start to build a little fishing colony over here. You can attach these directly. Sometimes, yeah, this will attach directly to this building, so you won't need to worry about supply chains and shit, but it looks like I'm not going to be able to attach those any further. So I guess we're going to have... I usually go with 2 fisheries in the beginning, and then we'll build some roads there to connect them all together. Just in case. Registering new population class. Yeah, we got a new population class, because somebody here upgraded. Who upgraded? We have a new house somewhere? Yeah, right here. We have a new house, an ego employee, and he's got new requirements and things like that, but that's okay because we now have new buildings we can build, including tool sheds, which is the most important of all of the buildings. Or, well, you know, there's tools and then there's the, we'll put our coal here. We can also upgrade our depots, which we're going to need to do pretty much right away. Quick little autosave. What's this thing? Oh yeah, eco employee. Good for us. And then we need an iron factory here. Build another road. So what this will do is it'll allow us to start gathering the raw materials that we need to produce tools. Probably have a tool manufactory somewhere around in this area over here, hopefully with enough room to stay away from this. But we need to start doing that pretty much right away because we are already running out of tools, and we don't want to run out of tools before we have the ability to make more tools. Because badness will happen. Alright, so there's a iron smelter to smelt us some metal, and then we can use that metal to create tools. We'll put that right there. So now we have the ability to make tools, not very many of them. I think this will produce enough iron to cover two toolbox makers, but I don't know for sure. We need more power. Hey, little eco crafts. Some guy's driving hovercrafts near my house. Stop it. It's this guy, this dude here. Let's see what he has for trade. We can buy more tools off him if we run out and need to have an emergency tool gathering summit. These buildings here do impact the environment negatively pretty harshly, and that will actually have an impact on our tea plantations at some point too, because it'll reduce the productivity due to negative eco balance. The other issue is that every time one of these houses upgrades, it uses a set of tools, so we need to be building tools ASAP, and we won't really know how much how much we require in terms of metal until these things have started gathering enough iron to start supplying this guy right here. I did upgrade this depot. It'll give it more of these little cargo robots to move around, also increase its storage capacity. But for now, we're looking pretty good. We've got box making going on, we've got food, we've got tea, and now we have the ability to make tools. So we're slowly but surely. I'm actually going to turn off building upgrading here for now because I don't want it to use the rest of my tools before I need them. So now we wait until we have iron. I'm going to take a quick break here and then we'll see where we are. By take a quick break, I mean I'm just going to let a little time pass here to see how much more of this production capacity we're going to need. If I'm going to need more iron or coal mines as well, because it looks like we're gathering our. No, we've got enough coal now for it. We just need more iron. I think this guy should be delivering more iron to it. Yes? No, he was stealing metal to give to our tool manufactories. So we are going to need more of these, and that means we're going to need a shitload more iron and a shitload more coal. Or at least more iron. I don't think we're going to need more coal. Yeah, we've got excess coal and not enough iron. So we need one more iron mine somewhere, and I think we have a mine right here, yeah. Do we have. Hey, good. And now I can just make a little road over to this guy. Cool, our road goes over a mountain. I think we might need another depot for that though, because that's kind of far away from this depot, and this depot is covering the tea manufactory. So I think we'll just go ahead and give it another depot, just so it'll be all by itself. And now, at least this one will be supplied for sure, and we may have enough iron and coal to supply another smelter. But for now, I'm going to let this sit for a bit and see what happens. All right, now we can take a look at the depot and see that we've got excess coal and excess iron. You can see this little green arrow here means that the storage is filling up instead of depleting, so we can build another one of these, which is good because we're going to need as many of these as we can possibly get. And we're starting to get a lot more boxes and a lot more tools. These boxes I'm going to use to build more houses. More houses means more money, means more people, means more upgrades. So we will build there, and we will build here. There's a number of different ways that you can build these cities, but I have my own set way. It may not be the best way, but it is my way. And you're going to have to deal with that. So deal with it. I'm sure that there's some amazing way to build cities that I've never encountered before, but I just kind of don't care. Now, hopefully we can find out. Yeah, okay, we've got enough supplies for both of these, and then hopefully these will begin making so much metal that we'll be able to supply both of these tool manufactories and begin that process. Let's see if we have too much basalt. Yes, we have way too much basalt, which is good and bad. We're going to upgrade that depot, and then we'll build another smelter here because we need to be turning all of this basalt into boxes as quickly as possible. We need every box. We need 100 million boxes. So our food, we're gonna have to change our food production here. We're gonna have to start growing health food, which is a problem because as you can see here, we have access to rice, but we don't have access to vegetables. We're also going to need to start building lumber mills, which is a tough one for the eco people because, you know, you don't want to cut down trees and shit. These guys have vegetables. Do you have any seeds? You've got tea. Let's see if he has any other seeds. Rice? No. Fuck. Okay, so we're going to have to find someone to sell us vegetable seeds. I'm going to send my ship here out on a scouting mission to see if he can discover anyone who might be able to sell me vegetable fertility seeds. I'll just send them all over the damn map, trying to find something. If we can find some vegetable fertility seeds, we'll be able to do a self-sufficient island here, which would be ideal. But for now, we're still trying to focus on getting these guys up to full productivity. Everything looking good there. We found another island here. This island has corn and fruit, I believe. Yeah, corn and fruit. And it's also got a set number of minerals and things like that. I'm not going to worry about that for now. Maybe later when we're able to expand, we'll be able to grow our island. But again, right now we're just looking for someone to buy vegetables from. In the meantime, We should probably build a new depot. And we'll go ahead and build this out here. Wait, don't we already have another depot near here? Well, no, not right near here. Yeah, there's another mine here as well. We'll build this depot right here. And we'll use this as our lumber manufactory. So we need lots of wood, which is what she said. I will build one of you here and one of you here. And then what this building does is a tree nursery, and it will keep all of the trees in this area alive, which is a good thing for those of you who are not paying attention. Cost me a lot of tools to do that. Let's see, we've discovered a new island. Nobody lives on it though. We've got a deteriorating eco balance, and now we have acid soil. You can see we're at negative 28 eco balance. That means that these buildings' productivity will be reduced to 98% because of the acidic soil. No big deal though, because we've also got all those other bonuses. Now we should be producing enough metal to make. Yeah, we could probably afford another. No, maybe not. Yeah, I think we're at a good balance right now for our tool manufactories until maybe a little bit later. But for now, we're gonna deal with that. Our boat is still scouting. And let's see, what about basalt? Do we have extra basalt? Yeah, we still have way more basalt than we know what's good for us. That doesn't even make sense. Make even more box makers, because we need every freaking box. And I think it might be time to build some more houses. Build another 4x4 there, 4x4 there. Yeah, we got plenty of room to build houses here. Boom. More houses. This will be an information center building right here. So I'm gonna leave that for now, but we'll start building some more roads. Because we're gonna need them where we're going.
Locating island.
Another island has been found. And we're all roaded up here. Even have some extra roads. This is the area in which we'll be able to expand this set of buildings. So hopefully we'll be able to get a nice big city out of this. And let's see, how about our basalt? Are we starting to lose basalt yet? No, we're still not losing basalt. That's kind of concerning, considering how many box makers we have. We might have gone overboard on the basalt gathering. Yeah, we have got a good balance here. We're getting extra metal, so we can afford another tool smelter. And I will definitely do that. Let's actually make it here.
Registering energy shortage.
Energy shortage, no. We'll have to build another wind thingy. Oh god, no, not the wind thingies. Lots of islands. More and more islands. I'm okay with that. But let's take a little break here in a minute and see how long we've got recorded here after I go through. And I'm gonna upgrade everything I can here because we wanna have as much production capacity as possible. Extra storage space, more robots to deliver things. There we go, and that'll increase the efficiency of every kind of production thing. Where's my boat? Oh, it's over here. We still haven't found. Hey, whoa, we found Sokolov. Or, well, we found some of his boats anyway. Or Sokov. Sokow, whatever. He's up and around here somewhere. I'd love to be able to trade with him because I'd love to be able to buy vegetable seeds from him. But no luck just yet. Hopefully our scout ship will find him laying around here somewhere. I think 30 minutes per video ought to do it. So I guess next time we're going to be expanding our construction options even further now that we've got a crapload of tools being made, and we also have a crapload of boxes being made, and now we've even got a crapload of wood being harvested. Wait, no. Crapload of wood being harvested, a shit ton of houses, and hopefully soon we'll be able to find someone to sell us vegetable seeds so we can grow our island even more. And we can stop finding useless islands. I don't want islands with nothing on them, I want islands with people, because I need to buy seeds. Next time, with me.